Today, we'll be telling you about the first Tesla car with a hydrogen fueling system. The first Tesla hydrogen car was actually made by engineers who are not from Tesla. Is Elon Musk against hydrogen cars? And can these cars ever be of competition to Tesla's battery-operated cars? Stay tuned to the end to find out all about this. First things first, let's find out Musk's opinion on hydrogen fuel cells. Elon Musk has a long history of voicing strong views on hydrogen and hydrogen fuel cells, but it is true that Tesla tested one of its fully electric vehicles and was able to double the mileage range by adding a second hydrogen system to the car. We will let you know everything about it in a second. When the subject of hydrogen fuel cells came up during a debate with reporters at the Automotive News World Congress a few years ago, the billionaire and electric vehicle tycoon described them as extremely silly. "It's just very difficult to make hydrogen, store it, and use it in a car," Musk said. "The best case hydrogen fuel cell doesn't win against the current case batteries. So then obviously it doesn't make sense," he added later. Musk's opinions don't appear to have changed much, if at all, since those remarks. "Fuel cells equals full cells," he tweeted in June 2020, adding in July that year, "Hydrogen fuel makes no sense." First and foremost, what is the technology that Musk appears to be so suspicious of? Hydrogen fuel cell vehicles, also known as fuel cell electric vehicles, are similar to electric vehicles in that they employ an electric motor rather than an internal combustion engine to power the wheels. On the one hand, electric vehicles contain batteries that must be charged by plugging the vehicle into a charging station, and fuel cell vehicles use hydrogen gas and generate the electricity on board, according to the EPA. Fuel cells produce energy by mixing hydrogen gas from a tank with oxygen. Now, let's talk about the Tesla model, which was made compatible with hydrogen. One of the most well-known electric vehicles on the market is the Tesla Model S. The 75D has a range of 416 kilometers. In comparison, the 100D and the P100D have ranges of 539 kilometers and 506 kilometers, respectively. What if you wanted to take your Model S on a long journey? Sure, you could stop at one of Tesla's supercharger sites to charge it, but what if you didn't have to stop, and instead could travel for another 500 to 600 kilometers? According to this team of geniuses, all that is required is a small amount of hydrogen. According to The Drive's website, the Holthausen Group, a gas supplier in the Netherlands, was able to maximize the range of a Tesla Model S by effectively hacking in a hydrogen power source. The company is the first one in the world to manufacture a Tesla that is both electric and hydrogen-fueled. They even came up with an interesting name for it, Project Hesla. However, because Tesla was not involved in the deal, they had to purchase a second-hand Model S. When it came to taking hydrogen as a fuel source, Holthausen Group engineer Max Holthausen described the Model S's system as a big maze and had to come up with a solution to put it in action, which added to the project's difficulty. The team finally got it to work, and the Hesla now has two different power sources. The first is a battery that is pre-installed, and the second is hydrogen stored in tanks inside the car. The process is actually quite easy. Hydrogen molecules are pushed into a fuel cell, where an anode extracts their electrons, which then pass through a circuit to the battery, providing it with additional charge. The hydrogen is subsequently reunited with electrons at a cathode, where it combines with oxygen to form water and exits the fuel cell. In comparison to the Model S P100D's stated range of 506 kilometers, the Hesla's exceptionally efficient fuel cell allows it to drive nearly 1,000 kilometers with a completely charged battery and full hydrogen supply. So, what is the cost of hydrogen fuel cells? Hydrogen fuel cells are particularly expensive to manufacture since their designs require the use of rare materials such as platinum as a catalyst. Former European Parliament President Pat Cox claimed in 2014 that Toyota would lose $100,000 on each Mirai sold at first. Since 2020, researchers have been working on a new type of catalyst that they think may reduce the cost of fuel cells. Because the platinum nanoparticles are not covered over carbon, which maintains the nanoparticles in place in conventional hydrogen fuel cells, but also causes the catalyst to become unstable and denature over time, requiring even more platinum. this new catalyst consumes significantly less platinum. Hopium, a French firm, has created a stylish hydrogen-fueled sports car that it thinks will compete with Tesla in the zero-emissions vehicle race. In June, Hopium launched a prototype for their luxury car, the Machina, led by French racing driver Olivier Lombard. According to the business, the hydrogen-powered vehicle has 500 horsepower and a range of 1,000 kilometers. Customers will have to wait, as the car won't be available until 2025 at the earliest. It's true that we are compared a lot with Tesla, and our ambition is to have a higher-end car and to try to have a big experience for the driver using hydrogen, Lombard told Euronews Next at the VivaTech 2021 conference in Paris. He also said that he's not here to compare his company to Tesla. In fact, he said that he has taken a lot of inspiration from the automaker and aims to do business like them. Hopium has only made one prototype of the Machina, the Alpha Zero. The production version of the Machina is expected to start deliveries in 2025, and the business is presently taking deposits for the first 1,000 cars. With increasing competition in the market, there may be one question left in your mind, and that is, which should be your ideal choice, hydrogen or electric? Before we answer this question, we would like to thank you for sticking with us. You can extend your support by subscribing to Elon Musk Facts and liking the video. Now, let us check out the hydrogen-electric comparison. Hopium has called hydrogen the future of the world. The fuel cell technology on the Machina converts oxygen and hydrogen into power while emitting only water. Unlike batteries, hydrogen fuel cells do not store electricity. Instead, they get hydrogen from a tank. A high-end electric automobile, according to Lombard, may have a battery weighing 600 to 700 kilograms. One disadvantage of electric vehicles is that their batteries contain materials such as lithium and cobalt, which are mined in environmentally destructive ways. The Machina's fuel cell, according to Lombard, included fewer bad elements. It was unclear whether Hopium's intended vehicle buffer battery would be able to do the same. Other than that, hydrogen cars are much faster to refuel as well. Imagine this, you are on the road to go for a long drive in your electric car, and after 400 miles or so, your battery is getting drained. So, you stop at a charging station, and unless you are at a supercharger, your car will take at least 45 minutes to an hour to get fully charged. On the other hand, a hydrogen car, regardless of which kind of refueling station it may be, has the ability to get fully gassed in less than 5 minutes, making it much more convenient for traveling. Other than that, a hydrogen model is also predicted to provide a longer range than an electric car. So what is the one big disadvantage of a hydrogen car? It is the same that prevents many of us from buying the car of our dreams. Yes, you guessed it, it's the price. A hydrogen car is considerably more expensive than an electric car, almost 30 to 40% more, making it for only a niche audience in an already saturated market. In the case of Hopium, their plans are to cater to the niche audience only, as they plan to sell only 8,000 vehicles by the year 2030, as compared to Tesla, which will probably cross the 5 million mark on a yearly basis. The Hopium is expected to be sold at $135,000, whereas the Tesla Model S starts from a base price of $100,000. While the battle for being the market leader keeps going on, Musk believes that electric vehicles are here to stay for the long run and cannot be replaced. Who do you support in this battle between hydrogen and electric cars? Let us know in the comments below. And again, thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.